morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Central Park United Methodist Church on this, the 11th Sunday after Pentecost, a very warm August 21st. Today's flowers are given by Danielle Matthews in honor of Jim and Beth Boyle's 42nd anniversary. Please rise as you are able and join me in the opening responses printed in your bulletin. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
We bless you from the house of the Lord.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
God's steadfast love endures forever.
Introduce our guest pianist today, Mr. Jesse Bonaventura.
Thank you.
still here, come on.
Good. Let's sit up here. Okay, I'll tell you what, let's sit like we were out on the grass. Let's sit over here, okay? Pretend we're outside. This is good. Good morning.
How are you?
Good, welcome. Hey, okay. Are you gonna, you're coming, right? Yes, okay. Hello, hey, there you are. I was wondering where you were. I have a story about a little blue flower. There was a little girl who lived in Buffalo. She heard about a little beautiful flower. It was blue. She decided to find that flower, so she took a trip to Kansas. They have a lot of rare flowers. But she couldn't find the little blue flower. So she took another trip to Mexico. They have many flowers that are beautiful. But she didn't find the little blue flower. So she thought, maybe I can find it in Ireland. So she took a trip to Ireland and walked many miles, but she didn't find the little blue flower. She returned home. She was very sad. Her mother made her a sandwich, and she took it outside on the back steps. She took only one bite of the sandwich when she saw something in the grass. It was a little flower. She got closer. And the closer she got, she could see the color of the flower. It was blue. She got a big smile on her face. She found the little blue flower. Not in Kansas, not in Mexico, not even in Ireland, but right in her own backyard. Sometimes you think that you should be looking in other places for things that will make you happy, when you can find them right where you are. Can we say a prayer? Dear God, we know that you are always with us, and we love you, and we know that we can find happiness right with us, with our own selves and the people that are around us. Amen.
Morning is from Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 4 through 10, found on page 698 of your pew Bibles. Now the word of the Lord came to me, saying, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. And before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nations. Then I said, "Ah, Lord God, truly I do not know how to speak, for I am only a boy." But the Lord said to me, "Do not say I am only a boy, for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and you shall speak whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth, and the Lord said to me, "Now I have put my words in your mouth. See, today I appoint you over nations and over kingdoms to pluck up and to pull down, to destroy and to overthrow, to build and to plant." Please stand as you are able for a reading from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 25, verses 31 through 46, found on page 29 of the Bible. When the days drew near for him to be taken up, he set his face to go to Jerusalem, and he sent messengers ahead of him. On their way, they entered a village of the Samaritans to make ready for him, but they did not receive him because his face was set towards Jerusalem. When his disciples James and John saw this, they said, "Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them?" But he turned and rebuked them. Then they went to another village. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." To another he said, "Follow me." But he said, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." But Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead, but as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but let me first say farewell to those at my home." Jesus said to him, "No one who puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God." These words of life proclaim God's awesome love. And now, Ken Thurlow is going to share some message for us this morning.
Thank you, Jim. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Lady Sunday. I looked up lady in the dictionary, and it simply defined it as anyone in the church who is not clergy. So, we're all laity. Simple enough. So we are all laity today. Laity is the church. We do the ministries of the church, like Claire's Closet, teach Sunday school, help with administrative things, take care of the building, help with fundraisers, take care of one another, and support Bible studies. There are also laity-led ministries outside of our church, like helping in food pantries, helping the homeless, and visiting prisons. I refer to our Bible verse today, Matthew 25, 31 to 46, which reads in part, "Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who will receive good things from my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for before the world began. I was hungry, and you gave me food to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothes to wear. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me.'" Simply put, Jesus is telling us what we, the lay members of the church or laity, should do. Several weeks ago, Pastor Murray told us about John Wesley's works of mercy, compassion, and justice. Works of mercy are practices Jesus gave Christians to do as they follow his teachings. They are personal and social. Acts of compassion are personal works of mercy. They are what you do with a person who needs help. When you meet someone who is hungry, give her something to eat. When someone's loved one dies, you go and comfort them. When someone is a stranger in the congregation or your home, you extend hospitality. These are examples of acts of compassion Jesus practiced and taught his disciples to imitate. They are simple kindnesses that share God's love through you. Acts of justice are social works of mercy. They are performed by you and others united with the church and other institutions working for the common good. Jesus tells us to feed the hungry. He also expects us to ask why people are hungry, and then to organize and act to address the cause of our neighbor's hunger. Christians are commanded by Christ to care for the vulnerable, voiceless, and outcast by alleviating their suffering and to be the voices asking why. Followers of Jesus are charged with getting at the causes of our neighbor's suffering. Write letters to elected representatives, call them on the telephone, sign petitions, march, protest, be a well-informed voter, and volunteer to serve on a social justice campaign. Pastor Mary asked me to speak to you about my experience in prison ministry. I'm involved with Collins Christian Ministry, or CCM. Collins Christian Ministry began as a Kairos program and then became a separate 501c3 doing the same ministry under a different name about 20 years ago. Kairos Prison Ministry began in 1976 as a program called Crucio in Prison, based on Crucio movement. It was eventually renamed Kairos, which is a Greek term meaning God's special time. The United Methodist program of Walk to Emmaus is also based on Crucio. We serve at Collins Correctional Facility in Collins, New York. This is a medium security prison about 50 miles south of Buffalo. A typical pre-COVID weekend consists of 4 days, starting at 5 p.m. on Thursday and ending 7 p.m. on Sunday. There are usually 2 weekends per year, one in the spring and another in fall. Every Friday evening, some of us attend a gathering of inmates who have completed a weekend to discuss how their Christian walk has been going. A typical weekend usually consists of 40 inmates and an inside team of 24 men going in each day. There is also an outside team that does all the cooking, takes the group picture, delivers food and supplies to the prison, and organizes agape, which are letters and notes of encouragement for the inmates. Sadly, we have not been allowed to host a weekend since March of 2020. There is a new chaplain and superintendent of the prison. There are a lot of new regulations and changes in place. Our Friday night visits have just started, but there are no dates for future weekends yet, and we're all eager to get back. Let me explain what one of our typical weekends looks like. The team gathers at Holy Spirit Church in Collins, which is a former convent. There are lots of small rooms for the inside and outside teams to sleep. After we have all picked out our rooms and had a light meal, we then go to the prison's gym. The gym has been set up for the weekend by the prison stewards. These are inmates who have previously completed a weekend. The gym is divided into a chapel with an altar and chairs and our gathering area with large round tables, usually 6 or 7. Each table has 2 team members and 5 or 6 inmates. These table groups are to stay together for the weekend. As the inmates come in, they are announced and are greeted by the table leader and given a name tag in the shape of a fish. The inmates are usually very cautious and not sure what to expect. They often come because they have heard there are cookies and lots of good homemade food. There are introductions and a few talks by team members, some songs led by our band. We finish up around 9 and head back to Holy Spirit Church. Now that we know the names of inmates at our table, we can address agape notes of encouragement to them. They receive these throughout the weekend from us and our support team, as well as members of our respective congregations. We are usually up at 5:30 in the morning for chapel, breakfast, and leave for Collins around 6:30. The inmates arrive to find an endless supply of cookies and coffee. They are a little more relaxed than the night before. We continue our talks, music, and sometimes make posters based on the talks they have heard. Lunch is at the prison mess hall, and the team goes with the inmates. This means prison food for us. The tables are turned as now the inmates help us get our trays, avoid the nastiest food, show us where to clean trays, and return our spork. No knives. We are inside. We return to our chapel area, and there are three readings by the stewards. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, Holy Spirit Church, the outside team has been preparing dinner for the inmates, plus inside team and stewards. Tonight's meal is all-you-can-eat spaghetti and meatballs with bread. After dinner, we prepare for our poster contest. To be judged by a team that's assigned points 1 to 10, based on an ever-changing criteria. After many laughs, since the scores are total for each table, mysteriously, the scores are always ending in a six-way tie. We head back to the ranch at 9 p.m. There are more talks, and the book table is set up by the stewards. The table is covered with donated Christian books free to the inmates. We again have lunch in the mess hall. After lunch is family chapel time. This is where each table and its team leaders go to separate breakout rooms. Each member is encouraged to be in prayer and tell the team what has been on their heart for the weekend. A member can only speak when they are holding the talking cross. It is a very serious and emotional time of heartfelt confession. Oftentimes, they remember going to church and Sunday school with a mother or grandmother, but then have drifted away from Christ. After this experience, it's back to the gathering room for songs and assignment of skits. The table members have to plan a skit based on Bible verses they are assigned and find props from around the room. A roast beef dinner has been prepared and delivered by the outside team and set up by the stewards. After dinner, we are entertained by the performance of the skits. After a break, I forgot to say that there are regular smoke breaks throughout the day. This is also an important time for the ministry. This is an opportunity for the team to engage in an informal way. Some team members join large groups. I like to find the one who's sitting alone and talk with him. We return to the chapel for the final talk of the day. Forgiveness of Others, Part 2. While the chapel service continues with quiet songs and Bible verses, each table family goes outside to burn the forgiveness slips they have been working on. Again, this is an emotional time as they often release a lifetime of hate, guilt, and anger. When the last family has returned to the chapel, we take them outside and walk to the prison fence. As they get closer, they see up to 100 people on the other side of the fence with lit candles, singing the same songs we've been singing for the weekend. At the end, each inmate's first name is called, and the people at the fence respond, "We are praying for you." We then walk back to the gathering area for dismissal. For me, Sunday is kind of anticlimactic, or I'm tired. As we are a very ecumenical group, we have two Sunday worship services, Roman Catholic in the prison chapel, and a Protestant service in the gym chapel. Afterward, the chaplain gives the talk, What's Next?, which encourages the inmates to participate in prison worship and attend the Friday grouping. The chaplain then hands out small wooden crosses to each inmate and says, Christ is counting on you. And I am counting on Christ. The closing ceremony is held in the prison visiting center and is attended by inmates inside and outside team and any other CCM volunteers not on team. Each inmate is allowed to say a few words, but the table leader is instructed to hold on to the mic, as many of them tend to get a little talkative after their weekend experience. Going back to our gospel reading, Jesus made it clear that being compassionate and helping others is not optional. Matthew 25:44-46 says, Then they will reply, Lord, when did we see you? Then he will answer, I assure you that when you haven't done it for one of the least of these, you haven't done it for me. They will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous one will go to eternal life. I've shared with you just a glimpse of what one aspect of being the church or the laity can look like. Where is God calling you to serve? Pray about it. Opportunities to serve those who are hungry, sick, naked, or in prison, going into some place like prison particularly, if you have never been in such a setting, is intimidating. God calls us outside of our comfort zones, sometimes way outside. But following God's call to serve his people, especially the least of these, is always rewarded with deeper faith, new relationships, and God's approval. There are many volunteering options right here in Central Park Church, as well as the city of Buffalo. Please see Pastor Mary or myself for ideas. Whatever your gift, talent, or passion it is, there is a way for you to serve. Amen.
Amen.
What you've done, but we do need your help. In addition, and I have pledge cards if you want them, but in addition, Pastor Drew Heights, Drew, where are you? Oh, Drew, we're having our second of three chicken barbecues this year, and Drew has tickets to sell. Yay! So buy them. Here's my friend Van, he's my counterpart, and Ken. Buy them, sell them. We need this to work. September 22nd is our chicken barbecue. So if you want to present this, I will say a few words. Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you, gracious God, for these gifts. Thank you for these wonderful people in our church. And thank you for the love of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And, wait a minute, oh, so you may be seated, but when his disciples asked Jesus how to pray, he said to them, say these words, and we're going to say now, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you. Excuse me?
How much are the tickets?
Oh, the tickets are $15 for a full dinner and $10 for chicken only. And we have to sell a minimum of 300. So talk to people, make them feel guilty. You know, whatever it takes, it doesn't matter. Just use all your persuasive powers. You can threaten them with singing if you're me.
Thank you.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord and to give shape to his kingdom. Thanks be to God.